There we go.
Okay.
Testing 1, 2, 1, 2. Excellente. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Just JP. My name is Justin. And today we're listening to a viewer's request and a request of many of you guys. Today we are listening to the band Return to Forever. This is the song The Romantic Warrior. Specifically, this is a request by Michael Loomis. So Michael, thank you so much for watching the videos, for commenting, and of course the recommendation. This is a band that many of you guys have talked about. I'm definitely familiar with Chick. I think that I've heard a little bit from DiMeola. I'm not 100% sure, to be honest. It's funny, just today I was actually listening to the album Fourth by Soft Machine, and I thought that they were more of a prog band. Maybe it was just my misunderstanding, but I was really surprised to find that it was just like jazz. It was good. I just wasn't expecting jazz. I was expecting like something different, but yeah, that album was pretty good. Thank you guys so much for all the support you've given the channel. Of course, if you enjoy the video, you can always like it. You can always share it. You could blast it out into the airwaves or into the netcode of the internet. I guess not really so much the airwaves anymore. You guys can also join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below. And let's get into it. This is Return to Forever with The Romantic Warrior. So I don't know what to say about it except that it is perfect. It's a masterpiece. I haven't heard anything like that in a very long time. I will definitely listen to this song again after I finish recording today. I may listen to the rest of this album after I finish recording today. That was amazing. That was awesome. It's with songs like these that I don't feel like I'm gonna have much to say because I'm just left so breathless, and I just don't have much to say about it. Wow. Okay. This is one of those songs where it's timeless. Not because of just its overall quality, but because there's so many little bits and pieces in there that just make it special, make it really good. It's kind of like Supper's Ready. Like, it's a long song, it has age on it, it's a little older, but no matter how many times you listen to it, it always has something there for you. That's what I can already feel like with this song. Did you guys like that, by the way? Let me ask you, like, what did you think of the song? Because I thought that was amazing. Was it busy? Oh yeah, it was definitely busy, but I mean that's the style that they're going for in this song, and I don't think it was overly busy. This was like you going out to eat and it's a nice restaurant and the wait makes it worth it for the food that you're gonna get busy. Not you're sitting at the waiting area for, a half hour, an hour, 2 hours, kind of busy. This was really good. Every single member of this band shined through or shone through, whatever, perfectly. Amazingly in the song. Just when you think one member was like the star, had like this amazing solo, this amazing melody they came down with, before you know it, it moved on to another section and someone else did the same thing or they just excelled at their instruments. Now, of course, me coming into this into them song, I am familiar with Chick Corea, so I'm familiar with his piano playing and what I can expect hearing him. And I got that. He's always going to be a superb pianist. I am always in all, when I watch him live, like on YouTube, or if I hear him on recordings, like here, I'm pretty sure I'm familiar with Di Meola, and his guitar playing was amazing. I love the little bit of Latin influences, maybe a little flamenco, maybe I'm reaching with that you hear occasionally in the song. It's like just a little bit. The bass. That was being played. That's by Stanley Clarke. And maybe I don't know bass that much, and I don't. But it sounded like, especially in that part, it sounded like the bass was being played with like a bow, like a violin or a cello bow. Like the way that it sounds. Right? And then if we kick it up just a little bit ahead. Back to like finger style, right? So I think that's really interesting. I don't know if that's exactly what he uses. I guess I could look it up on YouTube really quick to see, because I think that's a really interesting way to approach the bass. I know it's been done before, but I just think it sounds really good the way he did it there. It is. See, I'm not totally wrong. It was a bow that's being used on the bass. Okay. All right. Yes. All right. So 1 point for Justin. Man, I'm getting good at this music thing. But that was just a really nice way to bring in this brooding, medieval, according to the cover art, atmosphere into the song, while still adding all these like little Latin classical influences. The piano was a very beautiful build-up coming into the song. And then the main grooving already. Everyone is getting in on it. The drumming is absolutely astounding. It's so good. Listen to this. Listen to this main rhythm. Here we go again with the bass. Okay, so like I said, there are so many little moments in this song that if I was to sit here and cover them all, it would be like a half hour of video. And while I'm sure that you guys would like that, this is just a song that I would love to retain its magic. And just kind of hold some of it back for myself because I really, really enjoyed that. But there are so many little moments, like for example, in that section we just listened to with the bass, it gets back into having a little bit of a solo. It takes over right there. And there's sections where, of course, they all solo. That's a very key component of jazz and of fusion. Sure, that's nothing irregular, but it's just the style, the quality with which they do it, that makes this song stand above the rest, that at least I've heard. And the guitar solo. Beautiful. That is so good. I love when you can actually hear the fusing of two genres, of two styles as they come together and form something so beautifully. So, for example, for me specifically, what I hear in the drumming, it's very jazz influenced, yes, absolutely. But the actual work, like around the kick especially, the snare, it's very like, I know this came out in 1976. You can see a lot of progressive rock elements in it. So I just think the whole song is just magical. That is what I'm left with Romantic Warrior from Return to Forever, their sixth album released in 1976 with this song. It's magical. That's where I'm left with. Looking at the album artwork, I was expecting something, I guess, a little more like medievally, but I was very happy with what I got. I wasn't disappointed. That wasn't a knock. That was just an observation, a casual observation. This song is playlist. This is something that I would absolutely listen to. Like I said, I'm very serious when I say I'm going to listen to this more than likely tonight. I may get through this album tonight. So, Michael, this was a great recommendation. And like I said, I know a lot of you guys have mentioned this band as well, so I'm not forgetting you. It was just, it came at the right time. Sometimes, comments and requests come at certain times. Sometimes I pay more attention to them than others. This was one that came through. Seriously, guys, thank you so much for watching. I really don't have much to say on this one. I want this to be shorter because I'm just going to go back and enjoy this on my own. This was amazing. This was stunning. This was breathtaking. You guys can join me on Twitter. You guys can join me in the comments down below. I hope that you're having a great night, a great day. If it's late, go to sleep. Get some sleep. I'm gonna go have a cup of coffee. Keeps me up a little bit. You guys have a great day. Thank you so much. Bye.